This series, if you didn't already know, is all about making your Jayco Hawk a little bit easier to live in, a little bit more rugged, a little bit more off-grid compatible. So let's get straight into it. Video is going to be a rundown on our 12 volt system we plan to put in. So this is not going to be an install video. Just hang around, I'll explain to you what we're putting into our system and how they're going to play a part. First thing we've got right here is our charger. So our DC-DC40 from iTechWorld. This is the iTECH DC-DC40. It's a 40 amp charger. This thing can charge at 40 amps off the alternator of your car. It can also put in MPPT solar power as well. Very, very good quality charger, customizable. So this thing can run lead acid, AGM gel, calcium and lithium batteries. So the unit is fully waterproof. This is something that I really love about it. Obviously electronics are very, very sensitive to water and dust ingress. So IP67 rated is very, very awesome for us, especially being off grid and sitting in the bottom of our camper trailer. This is gonna be a really, really good feature to have. Obviously, if you guys are interested in 12 volt systems, you know that to get the most out of your battery, you need to keep it topped up. You need to have it fully charged as much as possible. So having a DC-DC charger works just like a 240 volt battery charger in that it charges your battery the way that it needs to be charged. This thing will prolong the life of any battery. Doesn't matter if it's lead acid, AGM, lithium, whatever you've got, any sort of DC-DC charger will help that battery. So having this is always better than just relying on solar or 240 volt chargers in between drives. Something that I do like also is that the charger comes pre-wired with Anderson plugs for your solar input, your alternator input, as well as your output to your battery. Really, really handy if you are buying one of these and you're not too confident in wiring or confident in installing your own Anderson plugs. Good that these things do come pre-wired, and then you can just buy Anderson to ring terminals and you don't have to worry about any of your own wiring, which is good to see as well. So that's how we're going to charge our system. Now on to the big 200 amp hour lithium battery. I'm sure guys that you already know what this is. I'm sure if you are here, then you have definitely looked into these batteries before. It is of course the iTechWorld iTech 200 lithium battery. So 200 amp hours of lithium power, LiFePO4, so lithium iron phosphate. Obviously that's the only way to go now if you're gonna do these deep cycle lithium batteries. There's a fair few reasons why we chose to go with this iTechWorld unit over some of the other ones. I did mention that I wanted to keep this as budget friendly as I could, while also not sacrificing quality. So I could have gone either way with this. I really could have gone super budget and bought an entire King's lithium setup or an all the really expensive and top shelf brands, but we are a pretty budget channel. We don't want to break the bank. We want to be realistic when buying our gear so we can obviously give the best advice to you guys. So that's one massive reason that we've chosen the iTechWorld battery. Let's run through a few specs, a few features, and I'll try to explain as best I can why we've chosen this. You guys would already know if you've been following us for a little while that we have a 120 amp hour battery from iTechWorld in the back of our ute. Now that battery is unreal and we had no problem going with iTechWorld again based on that experience, but 120 amp hours just probably wasn't gonna cut it just to power those little bit more power hungry appliances and the inverter that we plan to put in here as well. You get double the power at slightly less weight, so that's one massive advantage to having lithium, obviously, is weight saving. Now, lifespan. The lifespan of these batteries is rated at 5,000 cycles to 50%. Obviously, that will reduce if you take it down to 20 or to 10 or 30 or whatever you're gonna be using it for. But at 50% depth of discharge, if you have AGM batteries or lead acids, I'm sure you're used to only going to 50%, you can get 5,000 cycles out of one of these bad boys. Put it in perspective for you, an AGM, a good AGM or a good lead acid battery might do between 500 and 700, maybe 800, depending on how you treat it. If you're only taking it down to 70, 75%. But 500 is the average for a good AGM or a good lead acid battery. A Another draw for us for iTech World was the fact that they are a Perth-based company. The design for all their gear comes from Australia. Yes, lithium batteries aren't manufactured in Australia. I don't know of a single company that does manufacture these batteries in Australia, but the design for all these batteries, the design for the chargers, the design for all the gear comes from right here in Australia. It's developed, it's designed in Australia, and then obviously a lot of the gear is manufactured overseas. As I said, I don't know of any lithium battery that is actually built in Australia. Something else that we like about this battery in particular is the fact that they can be connected in parallel. So these things can be connected up to four in parallel. So you can have up to 800 amp hours at 12 volts, which is absolutely insane. I don't know any system that would need 800 amp hours worth of power, but if you've got that sort of requirement for power, you've got it there with one of these units. They can also be connected in series up to four again. So you can run a 48 volt system. A lot of American systems have 48 volt RVs and things like that. The big sort of Winnebago RV style setups might run 48 volt systems. These things can go up to 48 volts with 200 amp hours or any combination of the two. Discharge rates of lithium batteries are massively varied across the whole range. Continuous discharge is what I'm talking about here. Continuous discharge safely at 250 amps. That is way more than we'll ever need, way more than most people should ever need. And it's very, very safe. Obviously, I think the hardest thing that we're gonna run is probably a coffee machine, maybe a portable aircon when it's really hot. Even that would only pull somewhere around the 80 to 90 amps. I don't think we're ever going to get anywhere close to 250 amps. Now, the highest discharge current for short periods, so 5 seconds, that this is rated for is 500 amps, which I'm going to be honest, this is one of the highest that I've actually seen. This is rated for 500 amps for 5 seconds. How are these two bits of gear going to fit into the system? So, as I mentioned before, we are not just dropping this in as a direct replacement for our AGM, we're revamping the whole system. So you can see that we have the full river AGM deep cycle battery. It's 102 amps depending on how you use it. Obviously AGM, lead acid. You can see up here as well the solar charge controller that a previous owner has put in. That didn't come standard from Jayco, just in case anyone's wondering, but that was put in aftermarket by a previous owner. Now you can see down here that the Jayco iTECH system is very simple, it's very basic, but it's very embedded into the whole electrical system, so all of this has to come out. It's going to stay in place, but I'm going to wire this so it becomes redundant. Everything's going to be bypassed bar the fuses. I'm going to reuse the fuse block that's in the iTECH system, so there'll be more of that in the next episode when we install the system. But the iTECH system itself, the charging capability will be completely bypassed and the fuses will remain. Now the 240 volt, I will tell you what I do with the 240, but I'm not gonna be showing any wiring. If you do have an inverter going into your system, then get in touch with a licensed Sparky, get them to come out and do your 240 volt work. It shouldn't cost you that much. It's pretty basic, but I won't show you how to do that for legalities and other things. Obviously, if someone tried to copy or have a crack at it themselves and got hurt or lost their van or God forbid their life, then obviously that would shatter me. And yeah, I wouldn't be able to forgive myself. So I won't show any 240 volt wiring, but I will tell you what I do and how it works into the system. Righto, full disclosure guys. Obviously you guys know that I have the iTechWorld 120X in my ute and I absolutely love it. I talk about it all the time. It has not let me down and it's a cracker of a battery. I have reached out to iTechWorld to see if they'd like to collaborate on future videos. They've said yes. So because I am trying to keep costs down for you guys, I have got a discount code for you right down here. If you like the look of any of this gear, guys, you head over to iTechWorld, punch that code in, get 10% off anything you want from their shop. Make sure you use that code and make your order a little bit cheaper. Right, guys, stick around because in the next episode, we're going to be stripping out all the electrics from the Jayco Hawk and getting ready to put all this stuff in. And anyway, guys, let me know what you think. Let me know if you'd get something different. Either the 200 amp, is it too much? Is it not enough? What do you guys reckon? Let me know in the comments below because I'd be always keen to hear. Bye-bye. Catch you in the next one.